been around the game for so long and obviously learned a lot, been around Jerry for years. What was he like to you, and what he meant to, obviously, to the game of basketball?
What he's meant to the game of basketball is beyond really what you can put into words. I think everyone that I've heard thus far talk about him, the expletives are incredible, and how he's impacted the game. Take players that have had such a great impact on how the game is being played today, and go back to, you know, Bill Russell, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Magic Johnson, Michael Jordan, Oscar Robertson, Larry Bird, Tim Duncan, Steph Curry. I mean, all in some way have helped to change the game, make it better, and have proven to be winners along the way. Well, Jerry West has done that not only on the court, with the years he played, the accomplishments that he had, but he's done it from the front office position as well, where he has impacted and affected a franchise and helped build a franchise into one of the most talked about sports franchises of any sport. When you mention basketball, NBA, you think of Lakers, you think of Boston immediately. And part of that because of Jerry West, who played for the Lakers and then came back to lead them from the front office position by making shrewd draft picks, by doing outstanding trades along the way. And the results, I think, speak for themselves when you look up in the rafters and you see all those Laker banners hanging there. So he's just been so important. I don't know if you could have a greater honor than having the logo of our league with his silhouette on it, and everything that's involved with the NBA has a Jerry West logo on it, and that's why he was the logo. So it's a sad day, sad day.
When you say he is the logo, what an honor. What a legacy he has left.
Without question. And me personally, I hope they never change it. But as we know, things that withstand the test of time, sometimes people feel that, okay, it's been around long enough. Let's bring some of the newer generational people in to change it. But I would like to see the logo remain the same because of what it means, what he's accomplished, what he's done. And why do we need to change it? He is what basketball is all about. He's what basketball stands for. And I would like to see it stay forever.
He was an ultimate competitor, not only on the basketball court, obviously the golf course, he loved playing golf, but he was the competitor of putting franchises together after he played.
He loved playing the game every day, of calling some of the 30 franchises that are in the league, seeing what's going on with them. Who would not take a phone call from Jerry West, and who would not be open to a conversation with him? Let's think about it. He had the greatest accessibility of anyone to finding out what's going on with other franchises, because their presidents or general managers had such great respect for him that when Jerry West calls you and says, hey, let's spend a few minutes on the phone, I don't know. Do you know anybody that would say, no, I don't have time for you right now? I mean, that's what Jerry would do. He would stay on top of it. He wanted to know what every team is doing. And he would, you know, plan accordingly when it came time for trades and draft picks and signing of free agents. So he was very crafty with that, very smart. And as you mentioned, a terrific golfer, loved to play the game, and was very good at it. So not a bad basketball player, pretty damn good golfer. Pretty good office executive, and that's why he's going in the Hall of Fame the third time, this time around in September.
From a generation that has not been able to see him play, a younger generation, and now they're seeing videos, YouTube videos, he was just an unbelievable athlete. Forget just bat. I mean, he was unbelievable.
Imagine the toughness that he had to show up night in and night out, perform the way he did, and have the injuries that he had. I don't know. His nose was broken, I heard, like 8-9 times. And he wasn't sitting out 25 or 30 games with a broken nose. And he was a target. You know, people knew that they had to show up against him. They had to compete hard. They had to play hard against him because that's the way he was going to play. He was not only a terrific offensive player, he was an outstanding defensive player as well. And to get his teammates involved when the ball was in his hands. So, you know, he was a multifaceted basketball player. And imagine what he would have had endorsement-wise nowadays if he was playing in his prime with social media being what it is. I don't know if Jerry West wanted to have his own podcast.
He would have been a max player. He would have been a max player a gazillion times over. Somebody that went to the NBA Finals 9 times. What he's done, accomplished, is amazing. Like, not just from the basketball standpoint on the court, but what he did off. And we've saw him all the time at Clipper games. He was there right behind Steve Ballmer, breaking it down, watching the games. Like, he knew every piece that needed to be fit into that puzzle.
Well, let me throw one more thing out there. Besides loving basketball, besides loving golf, he loved fine clothes. And was a man who could dress. He made the clothes look better because they were on him. But he loved to wear the best that he could find and buy, and they looked good on him. That's special.
He did. Mike Fratello joining us right here on KTLA 5. Mike, thank you very much.